So the first strategy we're going to look at is the long division strategy, which is the basic strategy that most people, most adults have learned when they were in school. So this is a really common one. So I just want to, instead of teaching you how to do it, I'm just going to give you a couple of tips that might help you teach your students. So the first tip is to train students to know where to start. So I've often seen that kids don't really know where to start writing their answer. So how I train them is to look at the digit. If it doesn't go into that digit, then there is not going to be any answer here. So they're going to treat the first round of their long division algorithm as if this is the dividend, and their first answer is going to go there. Another trick is to teach students that after this initial digit, every other spot will have a digit as well. That helps kids keep from forgetting zeros when there is a zero inside of the quotient. The next tip is to make sure that the students keep their work area neat. One way that I have seen help students is to take a piece of notebook paper and turn it sideways so that there are columns and they can keep it all lined up and nice and straight. Another tip is to have students use a checklist. So here's a checklist that they can use. You can download this from the blog. Just cut them out and give each student one, maybe laminate it, and they can keep up with it with a dry erase marker. But it just kind of guides them as they work through the problem. Finally, as students are learning, and maybe students that need a little bit more support, you can use a net to help them. So this is a net. It helps the students understand and get in the habit of where to write things. But this net is especially useful because it shows the students where they're going to write their answers to each of the steps. So it's easy to learn the acronyms, McDonald's sells cheeseburgers, divide, multiply, subtract, bring down, any of those tricks that you teach your students how to remember the steps. But this net helps the students know where to write their answers once they've used that step. So this is particularly helpful too for students that need a little bit more support. So this is just the basic long division algorithm. You probably know how to do it. And so we're going to move on to the next one, which is the short division algorithm. The short division algorithm is my absolute favorite one, and it's great to teach students that have a good grasp on their multiplication facts and can find remainders in their head. So we're going to practice the problem 8,263 divided by 9. So you just want to have the students write out the problem. And I'm going to leave enough space in between each digit to carry any leftovers that we might have. So I'm setting it up like this. I've even had students divide their digits like this. And that helps them to keep everything sorted. So the first thing you're going to do is just start at the beginning and try to divide. 9 doesn't go into 8, so they could put the 0 there if it helps them. Or they can just go ahead and carry that 8 into the next column. So now they're going to be working with a dividend of 82. So how many times does 9 go into 82? 9 times with a remainder of 1. So you're going to take that remainder and regroup it over into the next spot. So now we have 16 divided by 9. So 9 goes into 16 one time with a remainder of 7. So we're going to put our 7 right there. Okay, and now we have one more step. 9 goes into 8 times. 9 times 8 is 72. So we have a remainder 1. Since there's nowhere else to carry it, we go ahead and write it down as the remainder. This short division algorithm is really great for students that have a good grasp on their basic facts, but also for students that have a hard time keeping everything organized and lined up as they do the long division algorithm. So maybe this is something your students will like. Okay, this strategy is called the partial quotient strategy. And the partial quotient strategy can look a little different. If you Google it, you'll see different styles of it. And this is one format that's pretty popular. Another format would put the partial quotients over here on the right. And so it doesn't really matter as long as you get the process down. So the process of solving a division problem using partial quotients is to take your dividend and subtract off parts of your dividend until you have nothing left. So you're finding these partial quotients, and when you're all the way done, you add up your partial quotients, and that's your answer. So let's look at this example. We have 5,432 divided by 4. And the first thing I'm going to do is kind of try to subtract off parts of this dividend. So I know that if I multiplied by 1,000, I would get 4,000 that I could subtract off. So I'm going to go ahead and make one of my partial quotients 1,000, because 1,000 times 4 is 4,000, and I can subtract that off. So now I have part of the answer, but I still have part of the dividend left. The part I have left is the 1,432. So now I know that if I multiply 4 by 300, I could get 1,200. And so I'm going to go ahead and do that. And I'm going to have 1,200. I'm going to subtract that part off. So now I have two partial quotients, but I still have a dividend of 232 left. So I'm going to continue going until I have no dividend left. So I know that 4 times 50 is 200. So I'm going to go ahead and add a 50 to my list of partial quotients. And I'm going to subtract that part off. So now I have 32 left. So let's say I could do 4 times 8 and get rid of all the 32, but this is a process, so you don't have to do it just the right way. You could maybe take off 8. So if you had 4 times 2, you could take off 8, and you would be left with 24. And then maybe you know that 4 times 6 is 24, and you've used up all of your dividend, and now you have 5 partial quotients. And so to find the answer, you would just add up these 5 partial quotients, 6 plus 2 plus 50 plus 300 plus 1,000, and that is your answer. This strategy is great because students can work on it bit by bit, and they don't have to put a lot of pre-thought into it. So this is one strategy that's really popular, and the last one we're going to look at is the area model strategy. This strategy, the area model strategy, is similar to the partial quotients. It just looks a little bit different. Instead of subtracting bit by bit off as you work through the partial quotient strategy, students are going to think ahead and get that set up right from the beginning. So we're going to solve 6,355 divided by 5. So the area model strategy requires students to break it into compatible numbers that will be the partial dividends. So I know that I could have a 5,000, but then I'm still left with 1,355. So maybe I'm going to break it into another 1,000 just because that's a nice compatible number. But then I would still have 355. So maybe I could break it into a 300. And then I would still have 55 left. And my last one is 55 is compatible with 5. So I'll just leave it like that. And then students can create the model showing the partial dividends. We have 4 partial dividends, and our divisor is going to be 5, and then they'll put their partial quotients above each section. So 5,000 divided by 5 is 1,000. 1,000 divided by 5 is 200. 300 divided by 5 is 60. And 55 divided by 5 is 11. So to find the answer, you just add up your partial quotients, and there it is. So this is a good strategy for students that maybe have a hard time keeping everything lined up in such a way that the long division algorithm or even the partial quotients algorithm requires. So lots of students like this strategy as well.